Coming up on Arkansas on Campus, students interested in studying abroad could be closer than they think, and one COVID website reaches out to the Black and Indigenous Arkansas community. Those stories just ahead. Arkansas on Campus starts now. Welcome to Arkansas on Campus. I'm Reagan Holland. Thank you for joining us. U of A students taking part in the Outreach for Inclusion and Diversity for Arkansas COVID. AOC reporter Sydney Mulvannon explains.
Thanks, Reagan. I asked a few of the Team BIPOC members to discuss their roles and the importance of the project. Now, let's take a look.
Team BIPOC is helping to inform all diverse communities of the state of Arkansas. Team member Lydia Fletcher explains how data plays a big factor.
The Marshallese population and Pacific Islander population has a much larger death per 10,000 capita than any other race in the data we've found so far. And so for me, it's like, I wanna dive deeper into that. I wanna figure out why, what kind of outreach are they missing? How can we prevent this and how can we learn from it?
One U of A grad student is taking on the role of team leader and discusses the ultimate goal for the group.
Whole BIPOC scene, we need more voices that are coming from Arkansas, from rural Arkansas. We need to focus less on Northwest Arkansas, which can kind of seem like, since we're in Northwest Arkansas in Fayetteville, we want to kind of focus on what's in our vicinity, but we need to broaden Arkansas COVID and make sure that we're speaking to everybody that needs to be spoken to.
Finally, Paige says spreading the word goes beyond the project.
It's extremely important to me. My best friend is El Salvadorian. I am part Native American. I'm pretty pasty though, so don't take my word for it. But it's just really important for everybody to be represented as they are. And I'm extremely excited that we have the class of Professor Reed. She is incredible. And I just wanna make sure that the voices that need to be heard are on the site.
The team hopes to continue the spread about Team BIPOC and finish the project in early May. Now, back to you, Reagan.
Thanks, Sydney. To learn more about Team BIPOC, you can go to arkansas.covid.com and search BIPOC. Students interested in studying abroad may be able to go sooner than they think. AOC's Maddie Dunn has more on the story.
Thanks, Reagan. It's been a year since almost 100 students were sent home from the Rome Center due to COVID spreading around the world. And now the Office of Study Abroad is hopeful that students will be able to go back overseas again. Take a look.
After facing challenges due to the coronavirus, the Office of Study Abroad is looking to open the University of Arkansas Rome Center in the near future. The Assistant Director of Study Abroad, Brian Pepsel, says the plans to reopen have been in the works since last year.
You know, we have been planning to reopen the Rome Center since we closed it down a year ago, and we've developed COVID operating plans in the same way that our campus has developed a COVID operation plan.
These new expectations include social distancing, hand sanitizing, and mask mandates. The director of Study Abroad, Sarah Malloy, says students have already gotten used to these rules.
The guidelines and those health considerations, they're not unique to Arkansas. They're not unique to the United States. They are a global kind of expectations.
Another new expectation includes less extra travel than students have done in the past. U of A student Lizzie Langford studied at the Rome Center last year and says she looked forward to the weekend trips.
I think my favorite part was we always had the Fridays off, so we would always be able to leave like Thursday night or Friday morning and go travel every single weekend.
Langford was one of the students that were sent home early due to coronavirus. She says it was a difficult and challenging experience.
I remember I got to the airport and my mom would not hug me. She's like, I don't know where you've been. I don't know anything about this.
For the staff of the Rome Center, the decision to send students home was not an easy one.
The benefit of hindsight is that we made the right call, and we made the right call at the right time.
Despite this setback, the future of the Rome Center is looking hopeful. Langford says she recommends Study Abroad to anyone and everyone.
The Office of Study Abroad is so amazing that they will work with you to figure out a program that's right for you, regardless of your financial situation, your major.
Pepsel says that many students have already proven ready to study abroad.
We have proven ourselves to be adaptable and perseverant and resilient. And those are all the things that would make you more successful in an international context.
The directors of study abroad say they're looking at all options, which do include virtual and in-person. Back to you, Reagan.
Thanks, Maddie. The Rome Center hopes to open in the coming months. Students can contact the Office of Study Abroad for more information. As the University of Arkansas continues to learn and adapt to the state's history of segregation, some historic figures' place is on campus is called into question. AOC's Tristan Hill has the story.
Thanks, Reagan. As we saw over the summer, the Black Lives Matter movement made its way to center stage across the country, and that includes the University of Arkansas. Now, some students say they're taking matters into their own hands to advocate for equality on campus.
As the country continues to challenge racism and division in its institutions, the University of Arkansas is no exception. Students have called for the removal of the names and likenesses of figures such as J. William Fulbright and Charles Hillman Brough, two notable segregationists with ties to the U of A. Some students say it's important to acknowledge the university's history while still seeking progress and unity.
I think going back, we can put, you know, maybe in the library just some information about what the buildings used to be if, you know, they do get renamed or anything.
That progress and unity are why some students are taking action to advocate for change. This weekend, the Black Student Caucus plans to hold a march across campus to call on administration to remove Brough and Fulbright.
The protest allows us to speak up and let not only the University of Arkansas campus, but the whole community know that we are here to stay and we want some change to be done.
And some faculty, including Provost Dr. Charles Robinson, agree that students have the right to protest.
I think students have every right to use their voices and to let the administration or the faculty staff know what their concerns are.
Robinson says that while there's no set plan yet, the university is open to having the conversation about how to make students more included and acknowledge the concerns of a diverse campus community.
Whenever there are concerns in the broader society, they will make their way to the campus, and we have to be prepared to have those conversations.
And with social media becoming a popular tool for students seeking to rally and spread their message, Robinson wants to remind the campus community not to fall prey to rumors about the university's plans.
Stay tuned to messages that may come from the chancellor's office or from my office.
Now, Robinson said he also wants to remind the campus community that while there is an advisory board in place to help assess Fulbright and Brough's place on campus, the final decision on whether or not to remove them is up to the chancellor. Reporting for AOC, I'm Tristan Hill.
Thanks, Tristan. Organizers say the protest is scheduled to take place this Saturday at 9:30 in the morning. It's slated to start out in front of the Fulbright Dining Hall and end with a march across campus to Gearhart. Three couples have started a small business that offers people a place campsite right in town. AOC's Heath Anderson has the story.
Thanks, Reagan. Camping. Some people love it, some people hate it, but a group of entrepreneurs has created a new way that has not been done here around the city. Check it out.
The Hangout, built as a campsite, is an Airbnb created in Fayetteville. Located off South School Avenue, the space offers an alternative to the traditional outdoor activity. Natalie Bailey, one of the partners of the business, says the team thought they could add a good addition to the hospitality sector. They started during the pandemic, but Bailey says they haven't been affected by it. It is not easy to start a business during any time, and there are several aspects that go into it. Bailey says one of the most challenging parts has been the amount of due diligence required by the government. The camp consists of two Airstreams available to rent with a hangout area in between. It wouldn't be considered the mountain man's camp, but that isn't the intention. Bailey says that this could be a good intro for someone looking to get their feet wet in the world of camping. Wilson McKay is an outdoorsman that is far from the novice. He's all for a spot like this to ease people into getting outside.
I think that really the outdoors are for everyone. And I know that that can be really committing to go on, say, like a backpacking trip where you're like carrying everything for the weekend, like on your back.
Between renovating, hospitality, and business management, a lot of work has gone into creating the space. But Bailey says that will prepare them for the future.
Bailey also told me that the group is working on incrementally and slowly trying to develop new Airstreams for the public to buy in the future. Back to you, Reagan.
Thanks, Heath. The Hangout is up and running again after some weeks of inclement weather. The COVID-19 pandemic has set many back. For Washington County, there may be a solution. AOC's Jose Carranza has more on the CARES Act at the courthouse. Jose?
Thanks, Reagan. After the second stimulus package was passed in federal courts, here at Washington County, there was a debate that sparked on how they chose to use those funds.
The Coronavirus Aid, Relief, and Economic Security Act set $150 billion for the Coronavirus Relief Fund. Washington County received over $4.5 million from the state of Arkansas last November. Yet since then, the money has sat in the bank untouched.
When there was kind of a question about whether the eviction moratorium was going to be extended, et cetera. And so we started asking them what they were going to do, and we got complete silence.
Pastor Clint Schneckloth sees the community's need for funding, yet the Quorum Court also sees another way to spend this money.
There are some that believe that the $4.5 million should be used to help people who are behind the rent, who are facing eviction. Now, there are others who believe that this money should be tucked away and saved in case we need it for a rainy day.
In the February Quorum Court meeting, one of these perspectives was brought forward with Ava Madison and her ordinance. It brought attention to the CARES Act funding and making a plan to spend it.
I know that Seven Hills Homeless Center, I know that churches, I know that folks are interested in seeing this money distributed. It does not distribute all of the money. It leaves almost $1 million to the county.
It met little support and was stopped there. Currently, the debate with CARES Act funding has seemed like a party issue, according to both Schneckloth and Washington. In March, Jim Wilson brought attention to the way ordinances were introduced, potentially affecting the debate.
If everything is as partisan as it has been, there's absolutely no way that anyone in the minority party would ever be able to introduce an ordinance without the cooperation of the other party.
Still hopeful that some of them will become, that some of them will be more reasonable and recognize that J.P. Madison's proposal is meets in the middle somewhere.
After communicating with Ava Madison, she explained to me that the ordinance she brought forth was actually meant to create a middle ground in the courthouse, as the courthouse actually had budgeted all the expenses that COVID would bring. For AOC, I'm Jose Carranza.
Madison's ordinance must be heard two more times in Quorum Court. The next meeting is set for March 18th from 6 to 8 via Zoom. That's it for Arkansas on Campus. Have a good day.